Hello guys, Sade Pandey here and welcome to this tutorial. And today we are going to take a look at script operator and we are going to recreate this portrait of Chester Bennington using script. So you can see like basically this cool shading going on, which is due to like what we have done is like wherever there are white portion of the image, the scale of the particle is higher. And wherever there is darker portion, so there are like particles are not present over there, or you can say like they have small scale. So basically that's what we are going to do. And this tutorial will mainly focus on like if you have a low to very little basic like knowledge of programming, you are good to go. But if you are like absolutely new to programming, so maybe I'll be like making more tutorials in future, so make sure you stick out. All right, so basically like what we are doing over here is like I have one image, like if I open that image, okay, so this is the image of Chester. And what's happening is like wherever there are like like we are converting this image into a black and white image first, like not physically, like our program will do that. And wherever there are like these white parts or bright parts, I should say, so there the size of the particles are more, and wherever there is this black or dark parts, the size of the particles is getting really low. So we are getting this kind of shading effect, and you can see it's all made up of small spheres itself. Alright, so if I show you script, it looks something like this, like it's nothing fancy, like nothing crazy, it's easy. Alright, so yeah, I'll start from a like blank scene. Okay, okay, so I'll take a plane and I'll set it to default shading method, and I'll go over here and in my diffuse I'll take a bitmap. All right, so I have the portrait over here now. Basically, right now, like I'll show you, like I've done this, this basic thing of like I've been playing with scripting lately, and like I'll try to explain you like how this thing really works, Okay, so what we need to do is first is like to change anything, we need to get the information, then we need to tweak it. Because in order to change something like here, what we are going to do, we are going to change the scale of the particle. So it's important to get the scale of the particle first and then change it. And then we need to set it back from where we got it. And then we need to evaluate. All right. So much of talking, and like now we'll just start. Okay. So I'll take a birth operator. So first thing that we are going to do is I'll explain again, like we will generate particles all over this surface. And second, what we are going to do is like we are going to get the UVs which are closest to that point, our particle. And from that UV, we are going to get the color value from from the closest point. And then we are going to drive our particle scale using same color value, and we will change it accordingly. All right, so I've generated particles over here on this plane. I'll just put it to like let's say 20,000, and maybe I'll add a shape operator. I'll choose like sphere, oh, sorry, cube. Okay. Alright, so yeah, so now I'll right away add a script operator, and whenever this is green, so that means like it is working. Okay, so I'll open script editor, and one thing that I'll do more is like I'll again add one more script operator over here, this won't do anything. We will just look at some codes from here, and we will, while we are working on this main event. Okay, so right now this thing is commented because it's having these slash, so we will just remove it, and this way our script is now working. All right, so I'll just delete everything because this is like example of a script that you get that you get by default. All right, so I'll just keep this part, these brackets, like our main thing is going to happen over here. Okay, so like whenever you start with any scripting or anything, you will have this thing, this for loop. This is known as a loop. And so what is happening over here is it's saying for integer I is equal to 0, I is less than event particle count, and I plus plus. That means we are giving a, this is like very basic of any script. You don't really need to care about this because you need to have this in all of your script. I mean, when you are not doing something maybe exactly same, you won't have it. But this is like what this is doing is this is iterating through each particle. It's going into each particle and getting information from that particle. So right now it says even particle count, like for all the particle count, we are going to iterate through each particle through this increment operator. So that's what I'm saying, like you don't really need to care about this. Our actual code is going to begin from here. All right, so okay, so we will start by by getting position of our particles, because we need to know the color which is closest to our particle so that we can apply that color value to the scale of particle. So the first thing that we need to have is the position of our particles in this 3D space. All right, so position, okay, so again position is a 0.3 data. So what is this data and stuff? So I'll explain you, if you see 0.3 is like Tyflow inbuilt data channel where you can store values like scale and position, and yeah, that's it. This is 0.3. So like as I explained, like if you are having basic knowledge of programming, whenever you call off whenever you store a variable, you need to define the class. So 0.3 is the class of that variable where we are going to store the position information. All right, so this is 0.3. 0.2, it basically deals with UV mapping. And then we have our, if we want to get a rotation value, that is saved in quaternion values, which is some advanced stuff to have, Euler, all those kind of angles and all. Okay, so I'll just explain everything while we are doing it. Okay. All right, so yeah, so first thing that we need to do is we need to get the position information. All right, so I'll make a 0.3 class, and 0.3 variable, and I'll call that pos for position, and equal to, which will be equal to, so here we are going to define the function. So that is tf dot get position. So as you will see, as soon as you write a correct code, it is going to become happy and it's going to turn into blue. Otherwise it won't turn into red or anything, but yeah, if your code or any function is right, it's going to turn into some color. And for functions we have this green color, and for these class we have this kind of color, like purple. All right, so yeah, so I did one mistake, so we will just put this down. So before right now, okay, so if I just make a search, all right, so I will do that from here, from this script operator. So we need to give some argument inside this. So if I go over here and if I search for get position, so as you can see, get position, this is the function and this is the argument. So inside argument, it's asking for a integer, and which is SINX, and it says get particle position from simulation index. So we haven't defined any simulation index, so we need to define that before getting any information, because we won't get any information without that. All right, so to get information, what's happening over here is like we are iterating through each particle, and then we are going to store that store those particles into some index. Now don't ask me why is it so, because I don't know. This is how, you just need to know that's how it works, and there's no quotient to that. I mean, obviously under the hood there's a lot of maths and physics, and no, not chemistry, maths and physics which is going under the hood, but on the level you need to do some stuff to get to some point. All right, so it's an integer class, so I will write int, and I'll write sim1. You can give it any name as long as you are able to remember it, and I will write over here is tf dot get sim index. All right, so again, as you see, as soon as I wrote it correctly, it turned to blue. Also, you if you are looking into some normal C# tutorials, so you won't see any TF, because TF is like, again, Tyflow class. So I mean, it says this flow because we are dealing with particle system, and that's it. You just need to add this TF in front, to the starting of these functions. All right. So get sim index, and sim index of what? Yeah, obviously. So we will write I over here, because we want to get sim index of all this particle count, it iterated through all the particles, and we are saving all those particles into one sim index, and we call it sim one. All right, so now, yeah, so now when we we are trying to get the position, point three position, we can define over here from sim one. All right, because now we have one argument. Okay, so what is argument? I'll again try to explain it quickly. So let's say there is some function, and which says do something, and that's it, do something, but do what you want it to do. So we have this argument, and inside the argument you define what that function wants to do, and this is predefined. You cannot just put anything, at least in Tyflow. So if you okay, so that's the thing. If you want to know about this, you can just go into just control F, and if you again write this get position, and yeah, so you can see it will tell you about everything inside, if you go inside what you need to write in those arguments. Okay, yeah, so you have all these things written over here, so you will have a basic idea of what to write inside that. Okay, so yeah, we have got the position of our particles. So if I just press Control E to evaluate this thing, you will see it says the script executed successfully, and that means we are not doing any mistakes yet. Okay, so it's a good habit to write one line and just execute your script if you are beginner or anyone who's having trouble, so you are doing it right, and you can get to that mistake easily. All right, so now when we have got the point position, now what we want is from that particle, we have got the particle position, so from that particle position we want the closest UVs of that object. All right, so we want to store that UV, because what we want is, we want to get ultimately we want to get the color from the this texture. So before getting color, in order to get that color, we need to get the UVs of that object, and from the UVs we are going to get the color. All right, so, and if you want to get the UVs, you need to have your point position, which we have already got over here. All right, so I will say point two, and I will call this UV. I will save this information inside a variable whose name will be UV, and I'll write over here all right, so yeah, before doing this, again I want to show you, because we are going to get UVs from this object, we need to import this object inside Tyflow. I mean, not inside Tyflow, inside our script operator. All right. So here you have a script accessible object. So you need to just pick this object. And as soon as you pick this object, you will see here it's written obj001. And this is what we are interested in. So we are going to, you know, guide our script to use this object. And you don't need to take all this plain and anything. You just need to take this obj001. And that's how it works again. Okay. So we will write. Now, yeah, so again, like now we don't need to write this TF because we are not referring to Tyflow. We are in fact referring to the object. So we will write obj001 and you see it turns like blue and dot. And we will write get closest UV. All right. So you see, as soon as we wrote that, like it understood. Okay, so if I again open my script over here and if I search for, you know, get closest UV. All right, so yeah. So here also what you can do, like if you're new, you can just copy paste this, you know, this code. Okay, so right now it's 0.3 because it's taking UVW. We don't want UVW, we just want UV. So it's it requires two arguments, and that is 0.3 position, which we have already constructed, and the int channel, obviously the same index. The int channel, which means like the mapping channel. All right, channel. Yeah, channel means the mapping channel. So inside of the argument, we will say you need to get the you know, the UVs from the closest position of the particle. And from the map channel, you know, here we are defining this map channel. So this is set to one, map channel is set to one. So we will just write one, and I'll just write. Okay, so every time you like complete a sentence, you need to make this sign. All right. So if I press Control E, again, script is executed successfully. That means like we are again not doing anything wrong, hopefully. Okay. So yeah, so now we have got the UVs. Now what we want is we want the color from that UVs. All right, so I will say float, because color is a float value, because we are dealing with black and white color right now. We don't want, you know, the RGB values. So that's why it's float. Otherwise it will be a vector or 0.3 or something. Okay, so float color, and we will store this in a color variable. And again, so we like UV, we get UVs from an object and we get color from a map. All right, so if we want to again use a map over here, again we need to drag it over here. So this is the map and we will drag it over here. Okay, so again it says text 001 and that is what we are going to refer again. So if you open your script again, yeah, okay, float color, and we will write text 001 dot get mono val. All right, so that means we are getting the mono value. So mono value means the you know, the black and white value, obviously. So again like I don't want to show, like I don't want to make you feel that there's any gamble, like I know these things and you don't know these things, so that's why I'm showing you every time. Get mono, if you write this, you will see get mono value. And inside the argument we need two information, and that is int t, which is time, because we want to, like you can read over here, get texture mono value based upon you know, on time and UV coordinates. So yeah, so time, that stands for t, because even though we don't want like the UV values you know, every time, because the texture is not changing, the color value is not changing, but still we need to have that argument. We cannot leave it blank. All right, so get mono value t, and from where you want that color, so UV, which we have already constructed over here. Okay, so again semicolon, and if I press Control E, yeah, all right, so it says the text 001 does not exist in the current context, and let's see what's happening over here. All right, so by mistake I dragged that texture over here, and that was my mistake. And again, it's something to learn from, because we did a mistake, and yeah, it's an opportunity. Okay, so yeah, as soon as we drag that over here, it turned green, because now it's accessing that texture. And if you press Ctrl E again, you can see like it's having that color. All right. Okay, so we did so if one thing in programming is like, if you it's really cool to back engineer stuff, because the final information that you want from there only you can construct the whole program, you know. Because what we wanted was color values, and to get color values we needed UV. Okay, so we constructed a UV. So to construct a UV we need a position, and to need a position we need a same index. So that's what I'm showing you. Like, you need to go backwards. Like, if you want color, just look from the you know, the code below, like the library, and you will get this arguments, and from those arguments you can just reverse engineer the whole program. All right, so now again, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the scale of the particles right now, because so I can apply that scale values to from our color values to our scale. All right, so I will make a, again scale is a 0.3 value, so 0.3, and I'll call it scale. And it's stored in, like, to get that value we need to type this flow dot get scale. All right, and that's it. We need to get scale from the sim index one and semicolon. And if you press Ctrl E again, it's working, because I'm so fucking smart. Okay, just kidding. Yeah, so we have got the scale. Okay, so if you see over here what I told you, like, get information, tweak it. So now we have got all the information, we can now tweak it, and we can okay, just tweak it for now. All right, so if I what I can do is, let's say, let me think. Okay, so scale, so scale is a 0.3 value, so it means it has x, y and the z stuff. So if I write scale dot x and scale dot phi and scale dot set, all right, so is equal to and is equal to and is equal to. Okay, so if I, let's say if I just give it some value, let's say 2 semicolon and 2 sorry, and again 2. Okay, so I mean, let's say on the z value, to make it more obvious, I'll put it to 10. All right, so if I press Ctrl E, even though script has executed successfully, but there's no change. And why is that? Okay, so first of all, I will hide this object. You can see there's no change. Like, even if I put this 10 to, like, if I change it to 100, just to make you believe I'm not doing anything wrong, nothing is changing. And why is that? Because I'll show you why is that. As I showed you over here, but wait, let me just save my file in case something goes wrong. Okay. Yep. Okay, so yeah, so as I told you over here, get information, tweak it. So we have got the information, we have tweaked it, and we need to set the information back from where we got it. All right, so yeah, even though we have tweaked the information, we haven't set it back. So that is one thing, we need to do it again. All right, so we have two things. This is TF, like, sorry, this is get scale, and then we have one like function which is set scale. All right, so if we write this flow dot set scale, and inside of set scale we need to set scale to same index one, obviously. And what's the, like, you know, the variable that is scale. And if I end it with a semicolon, hopefully it will work. Yeah, and it did. So you will see if I make it add 10 again, and if I press Ctrl E, okay, so it's working. And why is it working? I'll show you why. Okay, so what is happening, like, even though we got the scale and we tweaked it, but we didn't put it back, like we need to tell Tyflow that we have made some changes. Now you need to take it back and evaluate it. So you need to use this function which says set scale. And again, if I type over here and set scale, so it says set scale, and it will say, like, it will tell you that set particle scale from simulation index, and in the argument we have integer and 0.3 scale. So this integer is like obviously the same index, and 0.3 scale the new scale variable that we have constructed. All right, so we have like lot of set functions. Like whenever there is a get function, we need to set it again. So set spin, set velocity, set simulation, set export, set mat id, set position, rotate, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so we have so many things to set if we get. Oh. Okay, yeah, so all right, so we did that, but where is the effect? Where's the, you know, the fuzzing effect, because we are not having that effect. All right, so as I said, we constructed this color value so that we can drive our our scale from our color. Okay, so you see, we just need to write color over here on the X, and you know, there's a like easy way of doing this, but I just want to make this tutorial like simple, so I'm just doing it, you know, in a childish way. Okay, so if I press Ctrl E, yeah, boom, that's it, we got it. Now you can see the actual representation of the image. We are getting it over here, and I'm so excited now, because like how cool it is that if the script works. And if I add 10 more, yeah, this is so cool, right? We are having Chester Bennington, my favorite vocalist of all time. We are having his image, in our Tyflow. Again, if we add 10, it's going to look more prominent, because you know, it's giving more and more details. All right. Okay, that was quite a work. Okay, so if I like, there's one thing you can do. Like, let's say if you want to increase the, you know, the Z scale, so you can just multiply it by let's say 2, and if you Control E, evaluate it, it will increase the Z scale, as you can see. Yeah, you know, it's just increasing the Z scale. And let's say, oops, what is this, P, sorry. And if I add 20, so it will just increase everything 20 times. And like you can do this. All right, so this thing can be used in so many places, like not just this effect. You can make like, I saw some guy making a equalizer effect by just changing the, you know, the texture. And okay, so now I've said it, now let me show you. Okay, so if we change this image with just let me put another image over there, like texture. Okay, so this is some noise texture, and what I'll do is I'll put it to fractal and explicit map channel. Okay, so I'll just animate the phase. Okay, and I'll just scale down this, my plane. Okay, so yeah, now we are having this. So what I'll do is I'll just apply this texture over here, and in my script operator I will remove this texture map, and I'll drag in my new map over here. Okay, so yeah, now a cool thing is going to happen. Now everything will be driven by this texture, and if you play it, you are going to get this equalizer kind of effect. And how cool, and this is why we need to have this this time variable like that we imported over here, this in the argument, because it needs to sample time on the each frame. All right, so let's say you are you feel this is like by width, it's the width is really less, so you can just multiply it by, let's say, 4, and even in the length. Okay, Control E, so yeah, you will get them thick. And I mean, there's so much more you can do with script, and this is just the start. I'll be making more tutorials, so make sure you subscribe and you know, like just turn on the bell icon if you want. Like, so cliche. All right, so yeah, like you can generate, you know, buildings based upon your map, like based upon some map, and you can like vary the scale. Like, I mean, this, there are countless number of possibilities that you can do with it. So yeah, that's it for this tutorial, and I hope you like it. And if you have any problem, you can ask me in the comments. And if you have any suggestion for any tutorial, you can tell me that too. So I'll make another tutorial, and that might be better than this. Okay, thank you. Thanks for watching.